Hi friends, welcome. I'm Laurie from Wits,
and this is another picture book read aloud, an activity. Before we get started, let's do a little jig. I'm ready to move my legs and stretch them out and maybe get a little wiggles out. I'm gonna get a space here. Hopefully you do too. We're gonna listen to one of my favorite songs by a man named Bob Marley. Listen closely to the lyrics because they're very special, and make sure you get those wiggles out too.
Get up, stand up, stand up for your right.
Oh yeah.
Get up, stand up, stand up for your right.
Shake it out.
Get up, stand up, stand up for your right. Get up, stand up, don't get up the fight.
Sorry, boys and girls. Sorry, readers. I had to do it. I had to stop it. We have to have enough time for a book. Whew. I hope you got all the wiggles out. Let's take a deep breath together. Hold it. And blow out. I'm a little out of breath now. So, did you hear the lyrics? He said, get up, stand up. Stand up for your rights. The reason why I wanted you to hear those lyrics is because that man, Bob Marley, he is a change maker. He wrote those lyrics so that the world could change, and it did. They listened to his songs all over the whole world, and laws changed, war stopped, and people's minds were different after listening to them. Because guess what? Words are powerful, and you are powerful. And I bet you don't believe me, but you really can change the world. And as proof of that, we are gonna read a book today about kids who change the world just like you. It's a book called Let the Children March by Monica Clark Robinson. And the illustrations are by Frank Morrison. This is a book about kids who saw an injustice as something that was wrong and unfair, which was segregation, inequality and racism against people of color, black and brown children and families, and they used what they had to tell the world this is not right. During this time, there's a lot of hatred, there's a lot of pain, and these kids weren't superheroes. They were facing some really, really, really scary stuff, including police officers and angry mobs. And although they were just kids, they came together to give themselves bravery. They made signs, they shouted, and they kept going until everyone heard what they had to say. And it's kind of a sad story because they did face a lot of hard stuff, but it shows you that you can use words. You can use powerful ideas of your own, just your own body, and organizing with your own friends to make a big difference in this world. The activity is gonna help you do that a little bit. You guys probably have seen, and I know we've talked about the sadness in the world before, but I know lately it's been extra, extra tough. You've probably seen signs around town. And this is a sign that I made that say things like Black Lives Matter. They may say things like justice, peace, ends of racism. I made these signs, just like the kids in the book, to show the world what I believe in. I carried these signs in a march to show the world what I believed in. And me and my fellow protesters, people who believed in the same things as I did, we saw something in the world. We saw people getting hurt who didn't deserve it. We saw police doing the wrong thing. And we decided to use our voice, our bodies, and our friends to march to say this cannot continue. This must stop. This is wrong. And guess what? We risked maybe getting in trouble or getting hurt, but we knew it was important. And I want you to feel that strong too. Because you may not know this, but even just the signs, even just putting these signs where people can see them, have the chance to change hearts, behaviors, and more than you know, change all the people around you. Words are that powerful. Your words are that powerful. So after we read today, and while we're reading too as well, I want you to think about what things you see in the world that aren't right. What injustice, what unfair, wrong things that you would like to change. Now this could be simple as littering. You don't like when people litter. It could be that you see, you know, a kid in your neighborhood treating another kid badly. So you don't want, no hitting or bullying. It could be that you learned about something in the news that wasn't right. And then, just like these kids, I want you to download the activity packet and make a sign that tells the world what you believe in. Tell the world what is right, and or tell the world what's not right. So you could use signs that are telling the world what you want, like I wanted justice. Or you could tell the world what's wrong needs to stop, like no littering. Or in my case, no, the end of racism, the end of brutality. Now that's very big. So you can start even smaller. Like if your little brother is coming into your room a lot, you can make a sign that says, keep out. So you can make a sign for what you believe in and or a sign for things you want to stop. But both of those ways of showing the world on a sign are powerful. And I want you to have practice using your voice and being brave and standing up against things that should not be and that you want to change. I'm ready to read this book, and I hope you are as inspired by these children as I am. Let's get started.
Let the children march. Civil rights and the children's crusade. So here we have a timeline. Each of these children are holding a sign that has a date on it. And so these are just important dates during the children's march, and some that happened a little bit before and some that happened after are missing. Meaning this is not the full timeline of events for the civil rights movement. It continued for decades and decades, but these are important events for this part of the movement, the march that the children did. And so you should read them and make sure you're familiar with them. They're going to be illustrated in the story as well. But one of the most important events that happened in the civil rights movement and in the children's march was on January 14th. In 1963, when the governor of Alabama, Governor George Wallace, he made a very famous speech saying, segregation now, segregation tomorrow, and segregation forever. And with that speech, what he was saying was he would never allow there to be equality. He would never allow black and brown families, people, to be in the same places, get the same treatment, go to the same schools as white children. And so it sparked a lot of this movement and a lot of courage, because people saw that wasn't right and they were ready to march, they were ready to stand up. Ooh, look at these protest signs. They're red, they're big, and they say things like freedom now. They're powerful. 1963, Birmingham, Alabama. I couldn't play on the same playground as white kids. I couldn't go to their schools. I couldn't drink from their water fountains. There were so many things I couldn't do. One warm spring night, my family went to church. We weren't there to have regular services. We were there to hear Dr. King speak. We were there to plan. He wanted to raise an army of peaceful protesters to fight for freedom. His brown eyes flashing fire and love, Dr. King told us the time had come to march. So what he's meaning by fight for freedom, he's fighting for desegregation, equal rights for African-American people in Alabama, but also for the entire country, because the entire country was facing segregation problems and issues of inequality. If I march, Mama said, I'll lose my job. Sure enough. I can't march, Daddy said. I got a family to feed. The weight of the world rested on our parents' shoulders. But this burden, this time, did not have to be theirs to bear. Look at the emotions expressed on the mom and the dad's faces and the children. It looks like fear to me. I don't have a boss to fear, my brother said, or a job to lose. We can march this time. We'll be Dr. King's army, I said. I'll be fine, Daddy, I promised. Don't worry, Mama. You can probably imagine why they would worry. Dr. King didn't like children being put in harm's way. He was a daddy too, after all. But he said that though we were young, we were not too young to want our freedom. Let the children march. They will lead the way. So even though they were young like you, they had the courage to do what grown-ups couldn't. On May 2nd, a sunny Thursday, boys and girls, brothers and sisters, cousins and friends, we all met at the church, dressed in our best, feet ready. You notice the signs poking through at the end at the bottom of the illustrations? They had their signs ready. In silence, so loud that all I could hear was my racing heart, we began to walk. Hand in hand, we marched, so frightened, yet certain of what was right for freedom. The path may be long and troubled, but I'm gonna walk on. So you see, they're scared, but they still do it. That's real courage. Would I be hurt? Would I be heard? Would it all be worth it in the end? I wanted to run from the angry faces in the crowd, run from the danger, run from fear. Boys and girls, brothers and sisters, cousins and friends, on and on we marched, we marched, we marched, singing songs of freedom, 1,000 strong we came. Hate dogged my heels that day, its yellow canine teeth sharp, but courage walked by my side and kept me going. Dispense or you'll be jailed, the police shouted the first day. Dispense or you'll get wet, the police shouted the second day. Dispense or we'll release the dogs, the police shouted the third day. We did not dispense. We kept on marching. We wouldn't stop until the things started to change. Now, this is a very hard image to see, but these things actually happened. The police sprayed them with water hoses that were so powerful it ripped skin. They released dogs that bit at their skin. And all they could do was protect themselves with each other. Hundreds of us went to jail on the first day, and even more on the second. My turn wasn't until the third day. After I was sprayed by water stronger than anything I've ever felt, rough hands pushed me forward and I fell to my knees in the police wagon. I was going to jail. Can you imagine a child going to jail? You going to jail? Yeah. Dr. King reassured our parents. Don't worry about your children, he said. They're going to be all right. Don't hold them back if they want to go to jail, for they are doing the job for not only themselves, but for all of America and for all mankind. Can you imagine seeing children going to jail for just peacefully protesting? That night, crowded into a cell too small for even half the kids, we sang, "We shall overcome," and "Ain't gonna let nobody turn me round," and "Freedom is coming." Those are the different songs they sang. And our parents couldn't be there for us, but we sang, wrapped in the proud and loving arms of our ancestors. I was still in jail, but we heard that the next day and the next, more kids marched. The water hoses they used to sting us could not stop our fierce tide. So you see these children look scared, and you see those people with those angry faces. It didn't stop them. The path may be long and troubled, but I'm gonna walk on. How brave of them. Turn the other cheek, we had been taught. Show love when there is hate. The world watched as hate bruised us. But for 7 days, we walked only in love. The jail swelled to bursting, and even President Kennedy took notice. Daddy said the president received letters and calls about us from all over the world. Our march would become a memory, a small part of a larger story. But we had been heard, and the seeds of a revolution were sown. So even though the march was in Alabama, people watched as those children were hurt, and they were upset, and they stood up too. And even though those people were so awful, those kids kept meeting them with love. They weren't fighting back. And so it brought attention to their cause, and it helped change things for the better. 2 days and nights I stayed in the jail. Some stayed even longer. When I left, I was tired and sore, and my best dress was ripped. But my smile was as wide as the Mississippi River. I have made a difference. I'm so proud of you, baby girl, Mama said. Your march was what made them see. With nothing more than our feet, our voices, and courage, we had done what others could not. Change was right around the corner. We felt it like a cool breeze in the Alabama August. On May 10th, the great news rang out. Dr. King had reached an agreement with the white leaders in the city. Desegregation would begin. And so you see, although they were just children, and although they were just holding signs and walking, they were able to make laws change, and leaders and powerful people step aside for what was right. Powerful. 1 month later, I was playing in a playground I'd never been allowed to play on before. 2 months later, my family ate at a diner we'd never been allowed to eat in before, and our march made a difference. We children led the way. Singing the songs of freedom, 1,000 strong we came. And you notice these are all different races of children playing in the same park. And what she's describing is the end of Jim Crow segregation, which kept white and black people from being in the same spaces, living in the same places, going to the same schools. Wow. With just their signs and their march, they made all that happen. Just like you can. And here are real photographs from the children's march. See the children getting sprayed by hoses? They're very young, little guys, probably as young as you or even younger. And they were met by grown-up policemen and angry agitators who didn't like segregation, who didn't want equality and didn't want black and brown children to go to school with them. And even though they were met with all that hate, they made a huge difference in the civil rights movement. And you notice here, too, that Dr. King, his actual words were used in the book, because it says quote sources. So you'll see that those are actual words that the author decided to use in the book. And if you'd like, you can continue to read some of the things the author wanted to say about this book and also the movement. And once again, here is more dates from the civil rights movement that aren't the same dates as you saw before, but these are dates that are really important to the time around the Children's March. And you see June 11th, President in 1963, President Kennedy goes on TV to speak about civil rights, urging the Congress to pass legislation. all the way up to 1965 Voting Act that was passed. Now, even though this is an even longer timeline than the one you saw before, this is not the full timeline of the Civil Rights Movement, but these are very important dates to be remembered. The end.